Hey there, Mr. Reddit here. Welcome back to another episode of r/Entitled Parent Stories. Our first story we'll be reading today, Give Me Your Netflix That You Don't Have. After that, Karen loses it when I ask her to control her kid. And after that, Entitled Roommate gets what he deserves. Now for every thumbs up this video gets, one Karen loses her Netflix account. So please smash that like button. And if you're new, subscribe and turn on notifications for new stories from Reddit every single day. And join as a channel member today, and I'll give you a special shout out in our next video. Give me your Netflix that you don't have. I got a random message from someone I have never met before, and that person is horrible at lying. Entitled Mom. Hi. Me. Hi? Do I know you? No, but we could be friends. So, do you have Netflix? Me. No. Well, can I use it? I don't have Netflix. Please, only for 1 year. I was like, bruh. Me. I don't have Netflix, I told you. But I have Disney Plus. Ew. What if I pay you for your Netflix? I don't have Netflix. Please, I need your Netflix real bad. Me. If you say that again, I will block you. Wow, so rude. You have to give me your Netflix now because of your rudeness. I don't have Netflix. You don't understand. My daughter wants to watch TV. Then get your own Netflix subscription. If you have money for a TV and a device that could text, then you could get a subscription easily. I am a single parent. Well, that changes everything. Like, totally. Entitled Mom, not realizing the sarcasm. Great! Send me the password and I'll give it back in a year or two. Me. I was joking. Entitled Mom. How dare you! I am a single parent of a 16-year-old girl and in need of money. Me. Well, then sell your gosh dang phone or whatever you're using. Do you have no sympathy for a destitute mother looking for a free Netflix? I don't have Netflix. And you don't want my Disney Plus, so what could I do? You could buy me a Netflix. I'm not paying a random person on the internet $9 a month. And I can't buy a Netflix account without my parents' permission. I'm 13, you idiot. I'm 13 as well. You are the worst liar ever. You have a daughter 3 years older than you? I adopted her, idiot. You adopted someone older than you? Does that mean I can have your Netflix? Then I blocked her. What would you rather have, Netflix or Disney Plus? Please let me know, I cannot wait to hear from you. Karen loses it when I ask her to control her kid. I was talking to an old friend I haven't heard from in ages, and they brought up this story, so I thought I'd share it. I used to work at Dillard's, so I saw my fair share of entitled behavior from our customers, but this incident happened to my coworker. A customer was browsing around with her 4 to 5 year old son. He was running around, knocking things off racks, etc. The mother made no effort to control him until he crashed into her a couple of times. She told him to go sit in one of the chairs by the dressing rooms. The chairs were pretty nice and upholstered in a silk-like fabric. My coworker was removing garments left in the changing rooms, and as she passed by the boy, she noticed he was pushing a small car, think Matchbox-style car, all over the back of the chair, and it was shredding the fabric. She spoke to him and asked him not to do that. He responded by blowing a raspberry at her and pushed the car with even more force. She went to the mother and said, "Your son is destroying the chair with his little car. Could you speak to him?" Which is way nicer than I would have put it. The mother stopped and stared at my coworker. They stood there just looking at each other, which my coworker described as too long and very awkward. Finally, the mother asked, "So?" My coworker started saying, "Well, could you," and before she could finish the sentence, the single mother knocked her across the face with the hanger she was holding. So hard, it broke the hanger. My coworker just turned around and went to find our manager. She first encountered an off-duty police officer who worked security in the store and is a close friend of mine, and told him what had happened. He went with her to the manager. The manager went over to the mother, listened to her rant, apologized to her for the misunderstanding, and gave her a 10% discount for her troubles. My coworker was so stunned, she couldn't even speak. Even the cop was just saying, "What the heck just happened?" The cop turned to my coworker and asked if she wanted to press charges. Before she could answer, the manager interrupted, saying that wouldn't be necessary. Meantime, all the other employees in the department are watching all this go down, and I had just walked back in for my break. I see my coworker has a huge mark across her face. My coworker told the cop she did, in fact, want to press charges. The manager told her she couldn't do that if she wanted to keep her job. She told him that was fine. She quit. The manager was still insistent that the mother not be troubled by all this. The cop said, "She could have put her eye out, and I am arresting her. If you don't like it, you can take it up with my commander." The entitled mother was still acting smug until she saw the cuffs. Then she started screaming the usual nonsense. "I'm gonna sue all of you. I'll have your badge. Do you know who I am?" etc. No one but the manager cared, and she still went to jail. All of the other employees and customers who were watching clapped as she was being led out of the store in cuffs. The manager started in on the employees about how to correctly deal with situations like what had happened. We all looked at each other, and without saying a word, we all clocked out and left. All of us. Good luck running the entire department by yourself. We hung around our injured coworker until she was done with the police report and then took her to lunch. She said she had been planning to apply at a different store in the same mall anyway, but hadn't planned on quitting the way it happened and worried that Dillard's would give her a bad reference now. We convinced her to go to the other right then, injured face and all. She explained what happened to the manager there. She was hired on the spot and told they don't put up with crap like that. If a customer hits you, no matter who they think they are, charges will be filed and will be permanently banned from the store. I spoke to my cop friend a few days later, and he said the crazy woman nearly drove him insane with her screaming and threats on the way to jail, which wasn't close. After she saw that wasn't working, she started with pleading and bribery. He said he didn't think he had ever been so glad to hand someone off to booking. All this happened ages ago, and since that day, I've never stepped foot in a Dillard's. Entitled roommate gets what he deserves. Background. 1992. I'm a sophomore at a very large university in a southwest desert state. I'm living in the dorms with a jerk of a freshman roommate. At the time, I'm an engineering major, which means a lot of science and a lot of math classes. I also work about 25 to 30 hours a week because I'm putting myself through school. The scholarship only covers tuition and housing, but not books, food, or pretty much anything else I might need. My job is on campus, and since I was the new guy, my shifts were basically 4 to 10 p.m. with the occasional all-day Saturday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. My work was pretty much answering phones and dispatching technicians until 7 p.m., and then it turned into a computer helpline of sorts for the unsupervised terminal labs on campus. Frequently, there was nothing to do, so I spent a lot of time doing homework and playing X-Tank with other students across campus. Jerk Roomy, though, is a business major, with the quotation marks and everything, which in the early 90s was basically the same as undecided, so his class load was things like Sociology 101 and World History 101. If they had offered Underwater Basket Weaving 101, he would have signed up for it. My classes were spread out around campus, but having had my bike stolen the previous year, I got around campus on rollerblades. My math class, ODE, was held two buildings from my dorm, so that was just a short walk away. Like most major research universities, the majority of my classes were taught by teaching assistants, TAs. The incident. I came back to the dorm late after working an extra long shift. I had an ODE midterm the next morning at 8 a.m., so I set my alarm for 7 a.m. to be able to get up, get dressed, and have a quick bite before class. My ODE class was unusual in that the TA decided that he was going to have two tests and no graded homework for the entire semester. The midterm was 40% of the grade and final was 60. I had been studying for this midterm for the past couple of weeks, doing all the optional homework assigned while at work, so I felt pretty confident I would get a pretty high grade on it. Jerk Roomy was not there, and I didn't expect him there as it was midweek. His fraternity didn't usually start partying until Friday night. I took the opportunity to make sure I had everything ready on my desk before jumping in the shower and going to sleep. I awake the next morning to a ton of noise outside the door. I'm thinking, what the heck? I look over and Jerk Roomy is sound asleep. The room stinks and there's an empty bottle in the trash. I look over at my clock, thinking it's like 5 in the morning, and it is completely off. I start to panic and throw open the curtains. Bright sunlight greets me. Students are leaving the building in droves with their backpacks, bikes, etc. It dawns on me. It's gotta be close to 8 a.m. I rush over to my closet and check my watch. It's 8:15. Jerk Rumi starts to whine.
Close the curtains.
What the heck did you do? I yell at him.
What are you talking about?
He groggily asks. My alarm. What did you do to it?
Oh, I turned that thing off. It was too loud, and I don't have class until 11.
You jerk! I have an 8 a.m. I quickly got dressed, grabbed a couple of pencils and my calculator, grabbed my shoes, and ran out the door, looking like crap, but hoping I could make it in time and have some time left for the midterm. It took me 5 minutes to sprint to the building and up one flight to the classroom. I barge in, and the TA gives me a look. I quickly explain that my roommate turned off my alarm, but I'd still like to take the midterm and the remaining time left, and I'll take whatever grade I get, knowing that 40% of any points is better than zero. TA leans back in his chair and smiles.
No.
Huh? I must not have heard him right. I ask him to explain what he means.
No. You're more than 15 minutes late for class. I'm not allowing you to take the test.
I basically beg him in front of the entire class to let me take it because of circumstances that were not my fault. He gives this big smile and says,
I said no. That's the end of it. Maybe next time you'll consider my time and be on time for my class.
I'm literally shaking at this point. I'm so mad. I say in a loud voice, fine. I'm not setting foot in your class again until the final. And then I'm going to ace your final and make you grade it in front of your professor. He laughs and tells me he'll see me in May. I storm out. The Revenge, Part 1. Jerk Rumi was the first to get his. I just had to wait for the right moment. That moment didn't take too long. It was a campus rule that students under 21 were not allowed to drink in the dorms. Jerk Rumi had the same pattern every time he brought a girl over. He always put rubber bands on the doorknob to let me know he had company. The next time the rubber bands were on the door, I waited until I could hear them. Then I went and got the wing's resident assistant and claimed I had locked myself out and left my key on my desk. My resident assistant was a by-the-book Navy ROTC cadet, so he made me fill out the appropriate paperwork and then went to unlock the door. It was glorious. That was the last I ever saw of Jerk Rumi. Jerk Rumi's parents showed up the following week to gather his things. I didn't say a word to them, just put on my headphones and continued studying. Resident assistant told me later that he was expelled from the university for violations of code of conduct. One down, the TA was next. The Revenge, Part 2. Now every student has an advisor to help with class selection and sign off on things like grade replacement options or prerequisites. Normally, your advisor is in the same college as your degree, so technically, my advisor should have been from the College of Engineering. However, my advisor, Dr. Auld, was a family friend and a former high school football teammate of my dad's. When I was accepted at the university, he called and offered to be my advisor, even though he was in a different department. So, my first visit was to him to see what could be done about the TA. He agreed with me that the TA's actions were reprehensible, but quite honestly, the TA had the ability to deny me the chance to take the exam after showing up so late if it was in the syllabus. I asked him if he could find out who this guy's professor was so I could at least make sure that my final exam was graded fairly. I was more afraid that even if I aced the exam, he would lie and say I didn't. Dr. Auld agreed that should be doable under the circumstances, so he said he'd ask around. I then studied my butt off for the next couple of months, going to tutoring sessions and doing almost every single homework problem in the book. I spent a lot of late nights at work reviewing and re-reviewing the problems and sample exams in the book. Dr. Auld, during that time, got back to me and said he had found the professor in question and that the professor was willing to take the time to grade the exam. Then he told me that there was one other thing pertinent to the incident. This TA was definitely done for. Final exam. I showed up 30 minutes early, sat in the front row, dead center across from the TA's desk. Two pencils, calculator, and three sheets of blank paper for scratch paper and nothing else. No backpack, no notebook. We had to turn in all scratch papers as part of the exam to ensure that no one cheated or pre-wrote formulas or example problems on them. When he showed up, he was surprised to see me there waiting patiently. I told you I'd be here. The stare I gave him made him uncomfortable. I finished relatively early, which he noticed. He asked if I was going to hand in my exam. Not right now, at the end. When the last student finished and left, I stood up with him. I know you have received an email from Professor Young, and your instructions are to bring the exam to him for grading. That got his attention. I am going to be walking with you to the math building right now to take this exam to him, because I don't trust that you won't try to switch my exam with someone else's or lose it on the way. TA shrugs, gathers the rest of the exams, and walks out. We make it over to the math building, up to the 8th floor. I head to the math department conference room. The TA says,
"You're going the wrong way."
"Nope," I say. "You're meeting Professor Young in here." Sure enough, Dr. Old and Professor Young are sitting at the conference table chatting up a storm. On the table in front of them was the class syllabus. The TA, seeing this, gave me a look over his shoulder. Instead, I politely greeted Dr. Old and sat down next to him. Professor Young introduced Dr. Old as the math department head to TA, then asked me if I had the exam, which I handed him. He asked the TA for the answer key and then began grading. I sat silently. The TA fidgeted a lot, and Dr. Old double-checked the answers. Verdict, 100%. My D was assured. The TA got a smug look on his face.
"So, you passed the class after all. Congratulations."
"Actually, it doesn't matter. Dr. Old already signed the paperwork for me to retake this class in the summer as a GRO, no matter what the outcome here was. Grade replacement option, GRO, classes could completely replace the previous grade of an F or D in a class as if you had never taken the previous course, so the previous bad grade didn't count in your GPA. However, back in the early 90s, you could only do so 3 times in a student's academic career. You needed the sign-off of your advisor as well. By 1992, most every student at the university knew the procedure.
"GRO?"
says the TA. Then he gets this hunted look, as it dawns on him that Dr. Old is actually my advisor. He glances over at Professor Young, who is holding the copy of the syllabus. "So, TA," says Professor Young, "can you show me where in your syllabus it says that students will be prevented from taking any exam if more than 15 minutes late? Because that's not university policy." "And it's certainly not this department's policy," chimed in Dr. Old. TA grabs the syllabus and starts scanning it front and back, then slowly lets it drop back to the table.
"It's not in there, sir," he said.
"So, by denying this student the ability to take the midterm, you've violated departmental policy and academic policy then," replied Professor Young.
"If I recall correctly, this student begged you to allow him to take the midterm and said he would accept whatever grade he received for the limited time remaining in the class. Is that substantially correct?" "Yes, sir."
Both Dr. Old and Professor Young turned to me. "I think you should probably leave at this point," said Dr. Old. "We're going to finish this up and then discuss some personal matters. I'll call you later." So I got up and left. I'd be lying if I said I didn't do a little mini dance in the elevator on the way back down. I got an email a week later from Dr. Old confirming my GRO class registration, along with a note saying that the TA had been fired for violations of university policy. He implied that the TA's graduate academic work was in serious jeopardy as well, as the university would most likely not allow him to transfer and continue on his master's work to another institution. The icing on the cake was that the TA, being fired for cause, could not get another TA position at any of the state's 3 universities and did not have the means or the time to look elsewhere. So his student visa was revoked and he had to return to his northern European country. And yeah, I aced the summer class too, but this time I wasn't late for anything. Cousin demands my PS3 account. Backstory: my uncle and cousin are actually very nice people, but occasionally they can be quite entitled. I recently went to their state to pay them a visit. The other day, my grandparents sent me a text saying that my cousin wanted to talk. I thought this was odd because we never talked. On to the story. The cast. We've got me, we've got my mom, we've got entitled cousin, and we've got entitled uncle. Entitled cousin.
"Hi, is this OP?"
Me. "Yes, I haven't seen you in a while. What did you want to talk about?"
"I don't know."
"Well, I heard you just got into 4th grade. Do you like it?"
"No."
"Why not?"
"I have to learn."
Me, containing laughter. "Well, that's understandable." Entitled cousin.
"Do you have an X cube?"
"No, sorry."
"Oh, you have a PZ4, don't you?"
"Yeah, and I have a PZ3.
"What's your username?"
I give him an account name that's not my actual account.
"Okay, I'll friend you when I get home. I'll call you back."
He hangs up. He calls back.
What's your password?
Me. Sorry? Do you mean my username?
No, I mean your password. I want to use your account.
Me. Sorry, but no. I have money on that account, and I'm very protective over anything that I have money on.
Please! I don't have any fun games on my PS3, and you say that yours is fun, so why can't I just use yours?
Because, like I said, I have money on the account, and I really don't trust anyone with it.
Well, I'm your cousin. You can trust me.
Me. Sorry, but I don't even really trust my other siblings with it. If you want money on your account, you can ask your dad.
But he said you would give me money, so can you just transfer money to my account?
Sorry, but like I said before, I'm not gonna do that. We can play together if you want, but I'm not gonna give you any money. I hear him crying and running off somewhere. Entitled Uncle picks up the phone.
My son said that you wouldn't let him play on your account.
Why? Me. Because I have money on that account, and I'm very protective of it.
Well, he's your little cousin. He just wants to play your games. So what if he buys some?
I have over $100 on that account, and I'm saving it for when a certain game comes out so I can buy it, and some in-game items. Uncle.
Well, you can get more money another time, but right now, your little cousin wants to use your account, so just give him the password already.
Me. Sorry, but like I said, no. It's my money, and I can do what I want with it. If he wants to spend money, why can't you give him some?
Because I have better things to spend my money on, unlike games. I have a life and a job, something you don't. So just give entitled cousin the account already. I'm not going to continue talking about this. Don't make me get your mother.
Me. Well, I already said no, and I'm very sure my mother would support me. Uncle.
You are going to give my son your account now, and put extra money on it just because of this. You don't have a choice. I'm an adult, and you're a kid.
Me. Well, you live halfway across the country, so how are you going to make me?
Just give my son the account. I will not ask you again. You will also add an additional $150 because he deserves it more than you.
Me. No. Uncle.
That's it. I'm calling your mother, and she will give me all of your money, your PZ4 and your account password. You will also be grounded from electronics for the rest of your life.
Proceeds to call my mom. Mom. Hi, I haven't talked to you in a while. What's up?
Your son is being a brat and not letting my son play on his account. I want all of his money, his PZ4, and his account password. I also want him grounded from electronics for the rest of his life. Why aren't you responding? Respond now!
Mom. While you were complaining, my son informed me of everything that happened and showed me the call. So you can shut up and never talk to my son again. My mom later gave me an extra $50 on the account just for sticking up to him. He always makes me such a pushover because I'm a nice person. I was actually going to give my cousin $10 because he deserves it. Yes, entitled kid actually does deserve something, until my uncle did that. Now I have my uncle and cousin blocked, and I haven't heard from them since. Karen goes crazy at the music store. This was a little while ago, so I'll be paraphrasing what was said, but I'll try my best to make it as accurate as possible. In the area I live in, there's probably two or three main music shops I know of, and two of which are in the same city, a few streets from each other. This particular store I went to has no uniform, but some form of ID. I think it was an ID card around their neck, but haven't been there in a while, so I can't remember. At this time, I had been playing drums in school for about 6 months and decided I wanted to buy a drum kit for my house. This shop had the best prices, yada yada yada, so I decided to go there. As soon as I walk in, I spotted a mother and father with a kid, probably 3 or 4, walking around. I went up to an employee and asked for recommendations and, funny enough, they gave me a recommendation. I hadn't been on an electronic drum kit before, but he was listing all the pros to them and the cons, and after plugging headphones in, he let me play and see how I felt. I'm a big guy. At the time I was 17 and was going to the gym a lot. I was probably a little over 100 kilograms at this time, but it was a mix of fat and muscle. One of the pros of this drum kit was that everything was movable, so anyone could play and not feel cramped. Very useful for me. About 2 minutes in, I saw the mother, clearly the alpha of the family, marching towards me. I paid no attention. I was looking for a kid, and maybe they were just on the way over here too. She stopped a meter away from me, crossed her arms, and tapped her foot. I stopped playing, took one headphone off, and the following conversation happened. Me. Hello? Entitled Mom.
Where would the best guitars be?
Me.
I'm not actually entitled, Mom cuts me off. You don't know? How would an employee not know?
Me, I don't work here. She seemed unfazed by this info.
Get me your manager, now. This is unacceptable behavior and a bad way of treating a customer.
I just stared at her, almost dumbfounded at how she mistakes me for an employee. Sure, they had no uniform, but I wasn't wearing anything to ID myself as an employee. I'm pretty sure the dad knew I wasn't an employee, but was too afraid to even challenge her. I should also point out, I look much older than I am. I'm also rather hairy and have a badly kempt beard.
Me, I do not work here. Entitled Mom, do not lie to me. I know you work here, and I'll have you fired for this. I know the owner.
I clearly displayed on my face my amusement. I started smiling, trying to control my laughter. Big mistake. She starts screeching at the top of her lungs, shouting and pointing at me, shouting about how I'm done and that I'm a bad employee. Actual employees came to calm the situation down a bit. I just sat back down and kept playing, and she kept shouting that I should be fired. She was eventually calmed down and taken to a separate part of the store. Now, I thought this is where it would end, and that I had a funny story to tell my friends and a memory to laugh at. But no. I decided not to get this version of the drum kit, but get a more advanced, upgraded version, which they didn't have in stock. The other store, a few streets away, did. So I quickly walked there, asking for assistance, and the same general process as before happened. I sat down, and as I was putting the headphones on, she walks in, demanding to see the guitar section. And to my luck, it was right beside me. I played as normal, testing out the features and feeling the way it plays. The dad lifts the guitar, despite it saying to ask for an employee to help, and hands it to the son, who instantly drops it. In my attempt not to laugh, I fake coughed and looked away, but she had heard. She turns on her heel and...
Do you know how rude? Why are you here?
Me, don't work here either. I did as any normal, sane person would do. Assume it's coincidence and move on. She, following the path of being senile, assumed I was obviously following her and harassing her. Entitled Mom.
You followed us here.
Me. I was here first. This clearly didn't matter as she called for security. Two guys, smaller than me, came over and asked if there was a problem. And before I could open my mouth, she said,
Yes, he is harassing us.
Smirking and smugly looking at me. At this point, I realized it could get serious. I stood up and said,
Me, check the security footage. I came in here first and didn't even talk to her. She approached me.
The two guys, knowing I had come in first, said to her it'll be investigated. She was having none of this, and as expected, screaming, shouting, and flailing ensued. I turned to one of the guys and explained what had happened at the other store, and he brought me away and sorted out with a drum kit. In short, forget that jerk. Accusing a large, built guy of this stuff could have went completely south and got me in serious trouble, but thankfully nothing came from it. I didn't believe people like this actually existed, but now I feel sorry for those who deal with them on a daily basis. Brofist to all those who deal with crazies every day.
And shoutouts to our regenerals of the day, Dylan, Sergeant Mason, and Potato Gamer. Become tomorrow's regenerals by leaving as many rees as you can in the comments below, and please listen to my playlist every night when you go to sleep.